Guess it's time to face the cupcakes. Worried that I chickened out?
No! I know you're not afraid of anything.
I mean, what's to fear? This is a great honor.
Right! Wait, I can't tell if you're being serious.
Well, there is one part that I'm really afraid of.
What's that?
I'm afraid that you won't get any food because I'm gonna beat you to the maiden's feast.
Dream on! Come on, Pokey!
Ah, sugar bunting. Where the sweetness is baked right in.
No time to go to town now. Get in the house. Get a move on, sis.
Hello?
Surprise!
Whoa.
Yay!
There is my Valoria.
Oh, look at my pretty girl. I can't believe. I just can't believe.
We're very proud of you. I think that's what your mother's trying to say.
Oh, she's not even dressed yet?
Can we do that after cake? Come on, cake first!
All right, but come on. Let's get this good time over with.
Oh, yes, cake. Now, where did I put that knife? Nobody touches that cake until I find the ceremonial knife.
Ugh.
Lavina?
What is it, girl?
Any idea where Mom's knife is?
We're late! If I knew, I would have cut that cake, shoved it down your gullets, and had us out the door already! Oh!
Can I ask you about the maiden's feast?
Weren't you paying attention in maiden training?
How many of these feasts have you organized?
Let's see. A new Grand Mag appears every 14 years, and I'd have seen 6 of them, so... Hey! Are you trying to get my age out of me? I'll never tell!
What is Mag Chathra?
The latest in a long, distinguished line of Grand Mags to visit our land.
Distinguished?
Well, anything that lives that long becomes distinguished. I mean, look at me!
Where do creatures like Mag Chathra come from?
They come from beyond the Plague Dam.
I want to go beyond the Plague Dam someday.
It's forbidden! But maybe you'll be lucky enough to be taken there soon in Mag Chathra's stomach.
How much do we know about these Grand Mags?
The Grand Mags have visited our lands for as long as anyone can remember. They hide in the wilderness for years, and then they come to feed. After feeding, they return to their land and, it is imagined, breed.
You actually imagine that? Why was I chosen?
In every town visited by a Grand Mag, the villagers vote for the maidens who represent their town's best qualities. So in other words, beats me.
Mag Chathra attacks other towns?
Of course! Mariloft just had their maiden's feast yesterday. That's how we know he's coming here next. They're a pretty tough act to follow. Amazing featherwork.
Okay, I think I know all I need to know about the maiden's feast.
All you need to know is how to look pretty in your dress. We'll take care of the rest.
So, why don't we just fight Mag Chathra?
Silence! Talk like that could ruin the maiden's feast. If you destroy the feast, Mag Chathra will destroy this village, including your family. Is that what you want?
No.
My grandpa doesn't look too happy about this feast.
Your grandpa is just stuck in the ways of old. Your grandma was the same way. Bless her soul. Not all of the town elders have stayed as hip and with it as I have.
I'd better go look for that knife.
And hurry. If we're late, you won't be selected and your family will be shamed.
Maybe the knife is under this towel.
Never gonna find it.
Dad, I hope you're not hiding that knife for your own good.
Know where Mom's knife is, Rocky?
If I did, we'd all be eating cake right now!
Where would I?
One of my mom's special dish towels, and it's still dry.
I remember I had it.
Don't suppose you have another knife in the back we can use?
I do, but your mom brought out a special one she wants to use. She wants everything to be perfect on your special day.
Mom, I was just wondering, what if we fought the monster instead of feeding it?
That's my girl! Now that's Beastender blood talking.
Please, my loves, don't make this any harder than it already is.
Grandpa Beastender?
Eh?
Do you know where Mom's knife is?
Wouldn't tell you if I did. I'm not doing one thing to help with this shame feast.
Yeah. I'm not sure how I feel about this maiden's feast either, to tell you the truth.
Then fight it, girl! Stand up for yourself!
I hope you're not filling that girl's head with nonsense, Brahmo.
Why do you hate the maiden's feast, Grandpa?
Because this used to be a town of warriors. It's a travesty, Vella.
Why'd we stop being warriors?
Levina Clench and her ilk said there was too much bloodshed, pushed for appeasement. So we went soft, became a town of bakers.
Hey, Gramps, want a cupcake?
Yes.
I'd better go find that knife.
Don't you dare. I hid it for a reason.
You did what?
Oh, nothing.
Grandpa Beastender?
Huh?
Hey, Gramps, want a cupcake?
Yes.
I'd better go find that knife. Grandpa Beastender?
Huh?
Not until I find that knife, young lady.
She already caught me using my fingers. Eyes in the back of her head, that woman.
It's definitely somewhere out here.
Hey, don't go get dressed yet. I don't want you getting cake on your good outfit.
Oh, a little frosting never hurt a maiden's feast gown.
Where is that darn knife? This stupid knife is ruined.
No backing out now. Too many people would see me.
Think, Morelia, think. It's just got to be.
I hope that dress isn't to scale. How would I walk in that thing? Grandpa Beastender?
I must be losing my mind.
One of my mom's special dish towels, and it's still dry. Need a towel, Grandpa?
Why? Do I look like some old drooling invalid to you?
I'm tempted to snap her with it, but I don't want to embarrass my mom. Need a towel?
Do you see any frosting on my face?
No. You're very neat.
I know how to hide the evidence of cupcake stealing.
He's already got a towel.
No, no, where?
Mom, I was just wondering, what if we fought the monster instead of feeding it?
That's my girl.
The only thing she wants is that knife.
Nope, not there.
Need a towel, Grandpa?
Where would I?
Why not?
You eat the one you've got before you grab another.
Mom, it's her special day. Let her have all the cupcakes she wants. Except the red ones.
You eat the one you've got before you grab...
Did I leave it in the kitchen?
For me?
Split it with you?
Deal.
It's definitely somewhere out here.
On second thought, you can have the whole thing.
Suit yourself. Now, where did I put that thing?
What thing?
Nothing. I didn't say anything.
Where is that?
Grandpa Beastender?
Huh?
Daughter's special day.
All right, time to serve this girl up. But first, can I ask just one more time?
Honey,
why don't we just kill Mog Chothra?
Here, here!
Oh, honey.
Oh, we're going to miss your sense of humor.
Majestic to behold. Awe-inspiring, powerful, mysterious. But Mog Chothra is more than that. Merciful and generous, Mog Chothra keeps our town safe. All he asks is may he pick some of our beautiful flowers as he passes through. Please come, Mog Chothra, and make your selections. Welcome to the Maiden's Feast.
Show him what you're made of, Ella.
I know he'll pick you!
This can't be right.
No, it's not right!
Come here, little birdie.
I
have a treat for you.
I make myself the center of any room.
Center of mass, maybe.
Hey, what do you say we break out of here?
Trying to get us all to quit so you'll win the feast, huh? Well, it's not gonna work on me. I'm in it to win it, baby.
Making me hungry.
I'm trying to make Mog Chothra hungry. These girls have it all backwards. Think it's attractive to starve themselves.
Want to trade something for a bite of that drumstick?
What do you got?
Need a towel?
Nope. They taught us to eat daintily in finishing school.
I'm warning you, buzzard! I will fuck you alive if you come near my food again!
How about the satisfaction of helping out a fellow maiden?
Sounds good, but not half as satisfying as this drumstick.
Never mind. Just wanted to say good luck. Bye.
No more hugs.
Hey, does that costume have any thorns we can use as weapons?
Does, but they're made out of chocolate. Regardless, I accept my noble burden, not with apprehension, but with joy. I give my life so that no harm comes to our village.
No! I give my life!
No, me!
Sheesh.
Sorry, the beauty is nothing without it.
Why don't you come over here and give me a ride? When the monster gets close, you can use your candles to burn its eyes.
Don't distract me. I think I've got a chance to win this.
Ah! I've got a plan.
I already have a plan, thanks. Attract Mog Chopra with my slender frame and be remembered forever as a hero.
Well, good luck.
Yeah, whatever.
Here, you big dummy.
Now that's a sloppy eater.
We gotta get out of here.
Are you kidding? I've been starving myself for weeks for this.
Hey, can I have a drink of that water?
Trade you for that sweet corset you've got on. Never can be too thin.
This horrible thing? You got a deal. Ooh, what a relief. I feel so much...
Oh, I'm sorry. But this thing's just too big for me. Trade back. Oh, that poor girl. Oh, no! That should have been me! Okay, here we go.
Come here, little birdie. I have a treat for you. How about the slimming corset?
Why would I want to hide my best assets from Mog Chopra? He'll be looking for a full-size meal after his long trip.
Oh, it's not over. Well, it's true I haven't heard you sing.
Much as I'd like to shred this thing, it might come in handy later. I'd never be able to cut through that thick hide. Even those eyes look armor-plated. If those are even eyes. I don't want to stab that bird. Want to trade something for a bite of that drumstick?
What do you got?
Never mind. Just wanted to say good luck. Bye.
Why don't you pick on someone you're...
Why don't you come over here and give me a ride?
Just try to grab me. I dare you.
Man, he is ugly. Shredding my mom's dish towel isn't going to help. One of my mom's special dish towels. Need a towel?
I always open the bottle carefully, so no.
Where does a thing like this come here, little birdie? I have a treat for you.
Hey, over here, you big dummy. Why don't you pick on someone your own? Someone who might punch you, like me! Just try to grab me. I dare you! Hey! Need a towel? I think you got a little maiden on your cheek there. No? Yoo-hoo! Over here!
Not working. One of my mom's special... Glad I'm not wearing that anymore. I think Mog Chopra is really more of a let-it-all-hang-out kind of guy.
No. my noble lord.
Much as I'd like to shred this thing, it might come in handy later. Need a utensil to eat that?
No thanks. I feel silverware detracts from the hand feel of the food.
I don't think I could hit her from here. Hey, Bluebird, can I get a lift out of here? It's hard to tell where the dress ends and the cake starts. I could cut myself out of this dress. But without that bird, I've got no ride out of here. Much as I'd like to shred this thing, it might come in handy later. I could probably... Come here, little birdie. I have a treat for you. Bluebird, can I get a lift out of here? I could probably slip it on her if she were a little closer. You come over here and give me a ride. Much as I'd like to shred this thing, it might come in. Want to trade something for a bite of that drumstick?
What do you got?
Need a towel?
Nope. They taught us to eat dainty.
How about the satisfaction of helping out a fellow maiden?
Sounds good.
How about the slimming corset? Never mind. Just wanted to say good luck. Bye. Can I borrow that bottle one more time?
Keep it.
Thanks.
I don't need it where I'm going.
Juicy drumstick than in any bubbly water. I could throw this at him or spray him in the eye, but he's so big, I don't think he'd even feel it. Come here, little birdie. I have a treat for you. About something bubbly to wash it down.
Well, thanks. Don't mind if I... Ah! Look at me! I'm soaked! Oh, God. Is he looking? Quick! Quick! Help me put myself back together!
A little help?
I've got a towel here if you throw me that drumstick.
You have a towel? Why didn't you say so?
Oh, how long have you been standing there?
Are you part vulture or something? How can...
Here, birdie. Oh, come on. So close.
Much as I'd like to shred this thing, it might...
Gotcha. This cupcake. You can have the bottom half.
Get back here, you crazy brat!
That's my girl!
She's doomed us all!
Mug Chopper's fury will soon rain down upon our village!
Hmm.
That's it.
Jesse brought back a girl with
him. Ooh, a new recruit. Time for your old man to become Mr. Smooth.
Hey, thanks for saving my life back there. Sorry I said you were part vulture. Hi, Birdie. You birds want to help me kill Mug Chothra? Don't take this personally, bird, but I gotta get out of here.
Hi, my name is Bella. What's yours?
I am Walter.
Walter?
Walt-er. With an apostrophe? We admire lightness in all things. No extra baggage, no extra letters.
Who are you guys?
We're the preeners, of course.
We take care of the nests and keep stuff floating. Super important.
Can you guys help me? I need to get back to Sugar Bunting right away.
You're from Sugar Bunting? So that's why you smell like frosting.
What's the big rush? Stay here and float a while.
I just escaped the Maiden's Feast, and now Mog Chothra is going to eat the town.
You what?
Why would you ever run away from such an honor? Such a joyous occasion. Hopefully, the upcoming ceremonies in Shellmound go more smoothly.
We just had our Maiden's Feast yesterday. It was awesome!
Brother Lightbeard was very pleased.
Good luck topping that one, Smellmound.
Well, I just thought maybe we could fight Mog Chothra instead of feeding it.
Oh, that sounds horrible. Why would anyone want to hurt such a noble, endangered creature?
Poor Mog Chothra.
Look, I just need to get home right away.
We have no way off this cloud, because no one wants to leave.
Mom says she does, but she doesn't really. Right, Dad?
I need to get to Mog Chothra, quick.
Good idea. If you sacrifice yourself to Mog Chothra, that might set things right.
He's very picky, though.
And you'd have to compete with the other maidens of Shellmound.
Did you say that the next Maiden's Feast was in Shellmound?
Yes. It's so sad. I mean, they're always trying to compete with us, but...
Oh, please. Shell Mound girls smell like old seaweed.
How do I get to Shell Mound?
Follow the stink?
Let's go back to talking about Mareloft.
I knew this magical place would win you over eventually.
Who's Jessie?
That big blue oligarch you rode in on.
Oh, really? I guess I owe her a thank you.
Actually, take my advice. Stay away.
Why shouldn't I talk to Jessie?
Well, one of her eggs went missing when she was out.
She's totally freaking out.
Yes, I don't think the golden egg substitute we put in her nest is fooling her.
Poor Jessie. Where did her egg go?
It's against the Greener Code to point fingers.
But Gus was on cleaning duty, and it wouldn't be the first time that oath fell through.
Shh, son. Remember what Brother Lightbeard said. Loose beaks cause leaks.
Any idea where I can find Jessie's egg?
If Gus really did take it, well, he is a little dense, mentally and physically.
He probably fell through the clouds and went splat in the forest.
Can you tell me about Brother Lightbeard?
Happy to. Harmony Lightbeard is a brilliant philosopher, spiritualist, and buoyancy instructor. We have followed Brother Lightbeard up to the clouds to learn about his philosophy of lightness.
Dad gave him all our money.
Quiet, Chit.
Oh, yeah. It's a surprise for Mom's birthday.
Don't the birds tend the nest?
Well, these birds are not exactly model homemakers. Left to their own devices, they'll lay too many eggs or get too fat. And then, poof, they'll sink right through the clouds.
Don't float, stay afloat.
How are we floating on these clouds anyway?
Volume.
No, son. Try again.
Jeez. Okay. Circumference?
Area.
Yeah. It's all about surface area. Pounds per square inch.
Well, I'll see you two later.
Farewell. Stick to the paths.
Stay on the twigs or you'll eat a pig.
No freestyling, Chit.
Sorry, Pop.
Any idea where I can find Jessie's egg?
If Gus really did take it, well...
Well, I'll see you two later.
Farewell. Stick to the paths.
Careful. Ah! I told you to be careful.
It's okay. It's just my whole livelihood is gone, is all. I'm sunk.
Sorry.
About what?
About your knife.
Oh, right. My knife.
So, what's your name?
Carl.
Carl?
No, Carl. It's Carol, with some of the letters removed for reasons that are too stupid to repeat.
Hey, can I ask you about those weird guys down there?
My husband and son? What do they do this time?
I think they're going to hurt somebody with those sticks.
Oh, my husband would never do that. Harmony has rules against fighting here.
Harmony?
Harmony Lightbeard? The supposed guru my husband followed up here. I think he's a nut, but I let my husband have his hobbies.
Your husband is following a guru?
He moved the whole family up here so we could study Harmony Lightbeard's philosophy of lightness. It's a midlife crisis thing. I'm just playing along.
I don't think those guys down there are working as hard as you are.
Oh, I think they are, since I lost my knife.
Is that all of them?
Well, there's McGee, my teenager. Off with her head in the clouds somewhere. You know what I mean.
You must be very proud.
Honey, I'm just trying to survive this phase. Honestly, I wish he had just had an affair like most middle-aged men instead of dragging us all up here.
Okay, enough about your family.
Oh, sorry. Was I going on about them again?
You can't make hats without a knife?
Hats? I make life-saving cloud shoes here. Or I did, until you came along.
You make shoes out of clouds?
No, shoes that keep you from sinking into clouds. They spread out your weight. Buoyancy is all about them.
Wait, I know this. Volume?
Pounds per square inch. Skinny little feet like yours shoot through clouds like chopsticks through whipped cream.
Do you really eat whipped cream with chopsticks?
Only when I'm feeling sad.
Why don't you use your teeth?
Shoes made of teeth? That's creepy.
Well, I'll let you get back to your work.
Ah, my work.
Hey, can you make me a pair of cloud shoes?
Well, I can't make anything without my knife.
Well, I'll let you get back to your work.
Ah, my work.
Hi, I'm McGee.
Hey, what's up?
Nothing.
What did you say your name was?
McGee. It's Maggie, but without the A. My dad's idea.
Don't you mind that your dad took the A out of your name?
Well, yeah, but my dad said, hey, losing an A is better than losing an I.
Your dad's pretty funny.
He used to be, before he joined this cult. Oh, whoops, did I say that too loud?
Your dad's in a cult?
He's just taking this Lightbeard worship a little too far. But it's okay. At least it got him out of his line dancing phase.
What are you doing exactly?
I'm taking care of these eggs. If it weren't for me, they'd, get dusty or something.
How do you get to the eggs in the high nests?
Oh, because I'm so short, you mean?
No, I...
I'm just messing with you. I have a ladder.
Hey, can I borrow your ladder?
Okay.
Huh, that's awfully small.
Hey, short things can surprise you, okay?
True.
Hey, is there any way off this cloud?
Think I'd be here if there were? We used to have a cool feather vader that went straight down to the forest below. But Harmony took it out.
Why'd they take out the feather vader?
Harmony decided that nobody had any reason to leave.
Maybe I should just jump.
Tried it. No good. Whoopsie-birdie guards catch you and bring you back. What you need is a ladder. But it would have to be much taller than mine.
Lightbeard's really serious about this lightness thing, isn't he?
Oh, yeah. People say he only eats feathers.
Ick.
But it's not true.
Good.
He only licks them.
Gah. Hey, what kind of bird lays those golden eggs?
Oh, those? Those are egg substitutes. We make them for the older, senile gulls who forget they don't have eggs.
Why are they made of gold?
It's the heaviest stuff we have. We want them to be heavy, so the gulls can't carry them off and lose them.
Hey, nice cloud shoes.
Duh. My mom made them for me. All the other kids have cool name-brand cloud shoes, but I get homemade. Oh, but don't tell her I said that. The shoe thing is all she's got.
Well, I'll leave you alone.
Okay.
Those don't look like Jessie's. Better leave them alone. I don't need a ladder hanging off of me.
Hey, that's my knife. Good thing it didn't land on anybody.
can't get up there.
I don't need a ladder hanging off of me. It's my mom's special ceremonial knife. Hi there. What do you birds do for fun around here?
Hi.
Can you make me a pair of cloud shoes?
Well, I can't make anything without my...
Well, I'll let you get that.
Say! That's some knife. Good balance, nice heft. Ooh, and a blood gutter.
No, that's for the filling.
The less I know about the knife's history, the better. Here.
Thanks.
I know, they're big, but you'll grow into them. Trust me, you hit 40 and you're gonna be grateful for a pair of comfortable shoes like that.
I can't get them to stay on my feet.
Please place your offering into the bowls of enlightening.
Hi, are you?
You may call me Fathur.
Oh, yes, excuse me, Father.
No, Fathur. Like a light, beautiful feather. But lighter. Harmony gave me that name. It's quite an honor.
What are you guarding here?
I make sure that Brother Lightbeard's time is not wasted. He's a busy man, you know.
So, you're Mr. Lightbeard's heavy?
Hey, there's no call for personal insults.
Can I go up and see Mr. Lightbeard?
All are welcome on Brother Lightbeard's cloud after they make an offering.
What kind of offering?
It's not the object that matters, but the thought behind it.
Huh, weird. Do you know where Gus went? He's got an egg I need.
That one is struggling with the concept of lightness. He is yet to give up even a single letter in his name. He's worried people will think his name is Gas.
I don't suppose there's a big ladder like this that goes down.
Last time I checked, most ladders go both directions.
Can I just go up the ladder without making an offering?
Brother Lightbeard gives you this opportunity to lighten your load for your benefit, not his.
Uh-huh. I'll let you get back to work.
May the wind be under your feet. Sorry, I cannot handle the donations directly. Please use the bowls. A light offering. Harmony will be pleased.
Hi.
Oh, my. A fresh face rises from below. Before you ask, let me answer. Yes, you may live here in Mareloth forever.
Who are you?
I am Harmony Lightbeard, the lifter of clouds.
Can you help me kill Mog Chothra?
Ah, what a thing to say.
Did you just lay that?
No, it fell out of my pile of... I mean, it must have been... Pay no attention to that.
Actually, I just want to get off this cloud.
Oh, I understand. You're quite mentally ill, aren't you? Have no fear, you've come to the right place.
I really, really want to get off this cloud.
Do you have any idea what would happen if people could just leave Mareloth whenever they felt like it?
Everyone would leave?
What? No!
Mareloth would become lighter?
Hadn't thought of that.
But no.
I could go kill Mog Chothra?
What an offensive idea. No!
People would become unenlightened.
So because I care so much, we have the Whoops a Birdie Network to make escape. I mean, unenlightenment impossible.
Hey, are you done with that golden egg?
That's mine. I might need it someday. Take it away.
I need it like a blue jay needs a bowling ball.
Oops! Heads up for there!
Oh.
Why do you have laces and a big bow in your cloud?
Oh, why, you see, I exude such a powerful aura of lightness, it's made these clouds hyperbuoyant. If I didn't lash them together, they'd fly away into the heavens.
Why are you up here so high?
I'm exactly as high up from Mareloth as Mareloth is from the forest below, to show that we're all equals.
I don't get it.
It'll start to make sense after a few weeks of meditation, my child.
Any idea where Jesse's egg went?
Losing objects is a natural step in the path to enlightenment. It's part of who we are in Mareloth. It's in our roots. Do not fear it.
Thanks for the help. See you later.
Be light, child.
Or for there. He's breathing. Better let him sleep. Carl was right. Turns out I am grateful for these shoes. That's not a good place to hang a ladder. He's breathing. Better let him sleep. Oh man, this thing is heavy. Better stick to the paths while I'm carrying this. Hey, that bird swiped my golden egg. Not fair. I stole it first. Hey, that bird swiped my golden egg. Not fair. I stole it first. Run while I'm carrying heavy gold. It's not for climbing eggs. Hey, that bird swiped my golden egg. Not fair. I stole it first. This looks like a fountain, but it's flat.
Much lighter that way.
please place your offering into the bowls of enlightening.
Hey, Father.
Father.
How's your head?
Oh, I'm used to it. Heavy things fall from Brother Lightbeard's cloud sometimes. He says it's part of my training.
I don't suppose there's a big ladder like this that goes down.
I'll let you get back to work.
Whoa, careful there. That thing's heavy.
Hey, girl. Hey, hey, settle down. I'm going to find your missing egg for you, okay? Hey, girl. Hey, hey, settle down. I'm going to find... Hey, girl.
Sorry, just passing through. Man, that sign really did not do this thing justice.
Listen, I can explain. I was taking Jesse's egg for a cleaning and... Hey, wait, who are you?
You're in big trouble, young man.
Oh, man, don't tell Harmony, okay? He already has it in for me.
Why don't you just let go? I'm 85% sure someone would catch you.
I'm stuck! I'm caught on this branch and I can't reach back that far!
What are you really doing down here?
I was just chasing some fruit that fell off that tree, and I hit a weak spot in the clouds.
Why would Jesse's egg need cleaning anyway?
Well, it didn't, but I needed the work credits to make up for some hygiene demerits I got last week.
Mind if I just squeeze past you?
Yeah, that's a good idea. Come over here so I can grab on.
No way. Well, you hang in there, kid.
Now just get over here, grab my underwear, and unhook it from this branch.
Sorry, I'm not going anywhere near your underwear.
Come here and help me!
Hey!
Great! Now let me just climb onto your shoulders!
Quit it!
And I thought I was clumsy.
It's empty.
Are you finally here to help, or what?
Hey!
Oh, man.
Hey, girl. Well, I'll see you two later. Those don't look like Jessie's. Better leave them alone.
Hi. Hey, welcome back.
So what's new out here?
Are you making fun of me?
Hey, what kind of bird lays those golden eggs?
Oh, those? Those are egg substance.
Well, I'll leave you alone. Those don't look like Jessie's. Better leave them alone.
Can't get up there. Big deal, bird. Like, I even need hooks now. Aha! Solid as a rock! Peekaboo! That's right. It's me, your worst nightmare. Hey, come back here and get your comeuppance. On second thought, don't come back until you get some pants.
Swiped my golden egg. Not fair. I stole it first. It's empty. Hey, that bird swiped my golden egg. Not fair. I stole it first. Wanna give me?
That's not a good place to hang a ladder.
Hi.
Those don't look like Jessie's. Better leave them alone.
Hi. Hey, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Well, I'll let you get back to your work.
Watch your step.
Did you know your shoes make excellent ladder supports?
Great potato mashers, too.
How's it hanging?
Good one.
So, how's the view up there?
I don't know. All I can see is my mother's disappointed face.
I really like your outfit.
Yeah, I liked it too. Not good enough, though, apparently. And on top of that,
The shoes were too tight.
Did you say something about shoes?
Yeah, why? You need some? Take these. I don't need any. I'm gonna sit here forever.
What are you doing down here?
I'm an offering for the Maiden's Feast. You can't tell? Jeez, it's worse than I thought.
Kind of shabby looking for a Maiden's Feast.
Hey, I can't help the way I look.
No, I mean the broken bird cages and feathers.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's because the feast is over.
Need help? Cleaning up?
Why bother?
Well, it's just kind of a mess down here.
So am I. That's why I like it.
If the feast is over, what are you doing here?
Rub it in, why don't you? I'm still here because I didn't get picked, okay?
Look on the bright side. You didn't get eaten by a monster.
I'd rather do that than face my family right now. Who am I kidding? They've probably already jumped off a cloud in shame by now.
I was in a Maiden's Feast too. Just today, in fact.
Oh, really? You didn't get picked either?
Well, no, I got picked, but I put up a fight and got away.
You... what?
I just figured, why not fight the monster, you know?
Yeah, right. You didn't get picked. That's okay. Pull up a swing and sulk with me, sister.
Look, I think it's time we start fighting that monster.
You're just going through that anger phase after not getting picked. That was me yesterday.
Well, I'll leave you alone.
Just like Mock Chothra did. I'm used to it.
What do you birds do for fun around here?
Hi.
Good thing I have these cloud shoes on.
Place to hang a ladder. That's not a good place to hang.
I don't see anything in that nest worth climbing in for.
Hi.
Please place your offering into the bowls of enlightening.
It's not for climbing eggs.
Haven't you heard Harmony's teachings about lightness yet?
I don't want to climb into that nest. It's full. I don't want to climb into that nest. It's full. I need to use a ladder to get up. Hey, girl. Hey, Hayes.
you finally here to help, or what?
What are you really doing down here?
I was just chasing some fruit.
Well, you hang in there, kid. Hey!
Great! Now let me just climb onto your shoulders.
Quit it!
And I thought I was clumsy.
It's Jessie's egg. Better get this back to her. Is this thing heavy? Now, let me explain. I didn't take... Oh, hey, you're welcome. Wasn't anything, really. I don't want to disturb the mother-child reunion. I don't want to disturb the mother-child reunion.
Please place your offering into the bowls of enlightening. Hang on. Before you get on that ladder, I need to think about this cloud's weight limits. 100 pounds per square inch in buoyancy.
Bombs away!
Hang on. Don't move.
Bombs? Ooh, pretty. I like how shiny the sun is. Hi.
Listen, I'm sorry. I didn't know you had feelings, okay?
Okay. I forgive you?
Oh, really? Great! Hey, who are you?
My name's Bella. What's yours?
I'm Curtis. Sorry, I thought you were a tree.
Have you always talked to trees, Curtis?
No. They only started talking recently. How can I cut down trees when they're screaming at me?
Maybe you shouldn't cut down trees then.
But I'm a woodworker. I can't cut down trees, where will I get my wood?
What are they screaming at you?
All kinds of really personal insults, like really over-the-line type stuff. It's been rough. But the worst part is not having any wood to build stuff with.
So you're a woodworker. Could you make me something?
Like what?
A weapon to kill Mogchathra?
That dude is a bummer. But I don't think I could make something that powerful. How about a nice three-legged stool? Yeah. I haven't done a stool in so long.
Okay, make me a stool.
I'd love to, if only I had some wood.
Listen, about that big mess upstairs.
Oh, did another tree fall on my roof?
Yeah, that's it. A tree fell on your roof.
That's cool. I needed a little fresh air in here anyway. Been kind of cooped up for too long, you know?
Will you help me kill Mogchathra?
Sorry, conscientious objector. But I'm not using my axe. You're welcome to it.
Ooh, think I could kill Mogchathra with that?
Oh, well, no. I really don't think anything could kill Mogchathra.
Catch you later, Curtis.
Beware the trees!
Nah, that doesn't need a new sun. Especially not a vintage crystal one. Hey, can you make me something out of the wood and this ladder?
No. They use these hollow twigs up in Mereloft for lightness. Totally uncarvable. But I like how it's not talking.
Someone's ripped the trees out of this painting.
They were looking at me.
Hey, here's some wood.
That wood is playing a vital security function where it is.
You using this axe?
Not until those trees stop talking.
Okay, then.
Please don't tell the trees I'm in here, okay? And when you hit the main trail, head east. There is an extremely territorial snake in the other direction.
Gotcha.
Wait, east? Or was it west? Meh.
Okay, which one of you trees has been bugging Curtis? They don't seem too chatty to me. Okay, now I see why the trees were freaking him out. It's trying to say something, but doesn't have a mouth. I have a feeling I might regret this.
Murderer! Axe-wielding psychopath, right here!
Shh. You'll wake up the other trees.
She's got an axe! Run! She's a murderer!
Okay, look. I'm getting rid of the axe, okay? Just stop screaming, please.
Ow! My trunk! I'm losing sap!
Murderer!
Please don't scream anymore.
You can't silence me. I'm going to wake up this whole forest.
I'm here on behalf of Curtis, the lumberjack.
That homicidal psychopath? I once saw him hack an old lady to death.
Wow. Really?
Yes. A 300-year-old spruce, mining her own branches. Then he comes along. And the next time I see her, she's a... Oh, God, if I say it, I think I might be sick.
Say it. What did Curtis do to the old spruce?
He butchered her. Turned her into a stool. Oh, God. I think I just threw up in my mouth a little bit.
Why are you so upset?
I just can't stand by in silence while you murderous humans mutilate my brethren. It makes me sick.
Are you magic? Can you help me kill Mogchathra?
Is that all you humans think about? Killing? You all make me want to puke.
You got a little something in the corner of your mouth.
Oh, that's just a little sap. I'm not ashamed. It's thick and natural, and I'm full of it.
Yeah, you are. Hey, can I have some of your sap?
You're just like the rest of them. You want to bleed us dry, steal all our thick, luscious, and incredibly useful fluids. You humans make me want to throw up, but I won't do it, because I refuse to give you the pleasure of my sap.
I've never seen a talking tree before.
Well, I've seen plenty of axe-wielding, murderous humans, so get lost.
I'll let you get back to your screaming.
Yeah, please leave before I vomit, you foul, rootless stump.
I've got a ladder in my pocket. Bet that will make you barf for sure.
Is it from Mereloft? They only use naturally fallen branches collected by their birds. See? It's possible to live in harmony with nature, you barbarian.
Dang. It does have feet on the bottom, but they're too big for these little cloud shoes.
That's not a good place to hang a ladder.
Look, he also makes nice things that aren't wood.
Crystals have feelings too.
Looks like Mogchathra hasn't gotten here yet. Oh, driftwood. So smooth.
Hey, you taking a break, Clarence? Okay, let's...
Found some driftwood down by the beach.
That's morbid. But at least it's natural and hasn't been perverted by you humans.
Check it out! Non-talking wood!
Oh, and it's so smooth! Oh, man, I feel a stool coming on.
What? Oh, whew, that's a relief.
Tell me about it. I feel 10 times better. Thanks for helping me get that out of my system. I want you to have it.
Really? Thanks.
No problem. I like to spread my samples around.
To do this to you, but...
Oh my god, is that mutilated tree flesh?
You see, what Curtis does is he peels off the outer layer of the wood to get to the tender stuff inside. Then he dips the whole thing in an acid bath before he begins the deep carving. Oh, sorry, did that upset you?
Monster!
Wow, it's getting thicker every second.
Strong stuff, kid. Don't mess with it.
Wow, it's getting thicker every second.
Strong stuff, kid. Don't mess with it.
Wow, it's getting thicker every second.
Strong stuff, kid. Don't mess with it.
I'll let you get back to your screaming.
Yeah, please leave before I...
Excuse me, Mayor?
What? Mayor? Why did you say that?
Because you look like a mayor.
I have to admit you're not the first person to tell me that. But alas, I am merely Maiden's Feast Marshal Dune, a humble man of the people, for now.
I need to enter the Maiden's Feast.
Child, at this point, we may not even have a Maiden's Feast. Not that you have the right scent for it, anyway.
Are you saying I smell bad?
Oh, heavens no, child. You smell like birthday cake and fluffy clouds, with a hint of fresh pine. But that's just not the sort of aroma that hooks the big fish. Talk to your grandmother. I'm sure she has a fragrance recipe she'll share with you.
Did you say there might not be a maiden's feast?
The sea... She is angry this day. I'm trying to build the offering arena, but the waves keep washing it away.
There has to be a maiden's feast. I need to kill Mogchathra.
Yes, yes, we all want to fill Mogchathra. But when he comes here and sees no offering arena, he might pass us by, or worse.
Hey, about your bucket hat.
What? What about it?
Can I have it?
Certainly not. It's an integral part of my soon-to-be mayor look.
Hey, about your bucket hat.
What? What about it?
Can I please have it?
I like your manners, but I like my hat more.
So, you're running for mayor of Shellmound?
My hopes and dreams, just sandcastles built too close to an angry sea. I had hopes, child, but this construction debacle under my marshalship has washed them all away.
When is Mogchathra supposed to get here?
Any minute! So much to do!
Why do you build the offering arena so close to the ocean?
Because that's where the sand is.
Better let you get back to the feast.
Yes, yes. These maidens aren't going to serve up themselves.
Excellent. Surely this one will last.
That's not a good use for a stool. Want to see some pretty crystal?
Please, child. I just want to unload some maidens and go home to my sandcastle.
Nah, that doesn't need a new sun. Want some flip-flops?
Please, I'm in politics. I can't be associated with flip-flops.
It does have feet on the bottom, but they're too... That's not a good place to hang a ladder. Hi, you maidens getting ready for the maiden's feast? I want to be in the maiden's feast.
Of course you do, poor thing.
But shell maidens are chosen only after a long period of qualifying events.
Also, our dads are pretty powerful. Also, can I tell you something? Just as a friend.
Oh my god, yes, just as a friend.
You just don't smell right, girl.
Oh, I'd want a friend to tell me that.
Hey, can I have some of that perfume?
That's not perfume. That's a proprietary luring compound known as Beast Hooker.
It's irresistible to Mogs.
Hey, can I have some of your Beast Hooker?
That's better. But no, you can't. Sorry.
It's her secret sauce.
How about just one little squirt?
Sorry. If I'm not gonna give any to my best friend, Drusilla, I'm certainly not gonna give any to you.
I said I don't want any. I don't use performance enhancers.
Nice costumes.
Thanks. Our dads made them.
They're the best fishermen in the village, so they're pretty good at tying lures.
We had to use every hook in town, but it was worth it.
Isn't somebody gonna miss those hooks?
Not as much as they're gonna miss us.
You're gonna make me cry, girl.
Hey, maidens, I'm going to kill Mog Chothra.
Not half as hard as I'm gonna kill it.
I'm already killing it in this outfit, just standing here.
You maidens nervous?
Yeah, nervous that Marshal Dune isn't gonna get the offering arena ready before Mog Chothra gets here.
Oh, I can't believe our dad's donated so much to his campaign.
Don't you guys ever wonder if there's another way? To save the town, I mean.
This is how it's always been done.
Yeah, they figured out how to do it a long time ago, so we wouldn't have to think about it.
See you maidens later.
Ciao!
These fishing poles are useless. All the hooks have been stolen. Looking at this chum trough makes me really happy I grew up in a baking town instead of a fishing town. I just hope my baking town is still standing. These seagulls seem to really like fish guts.
No, no, not like that. Wait for the tide. Don't make me.
A sighted stranger approaches. Not so fast. Darn. All out of holy tear gas.
Use the staff.
Oh, yeah. Halt! The dead-eye god sees no one.
Who are you two?
I am Dead-Eye Dawn. And this is Dead-Eye Courtney. Hi.
What is this place?
The Dead-Eye Pyramid. Tomb of the Dead-Eye God. As if you didn't know.
Can I go inside?
You wish to invade our holiest of shrines? Why?
I don't know. It just looks cool.
It does? We wouldn't know. We're blind.
Oh, sorry.
But no one enters the Dead-Eye Pyramid. No one. Well, unless...
What?
Well... If she could solve the riddle of Yorn... Oh, yeah! If she could solve that, then she'd definitely be worthy.
No problem. Could you remind me how the riddle of Yorn goes one more time?
You always take us down when we are in our prime. Devour your sweet rewards, yet I'll return in time. A child of mine will rise... out of his rotten bed, up from a hidden pit, long after I am dead.
Whoa.
Yeah. Bring us the solution, and you may enter the pyramid.
Who's the Dead-Eye God?
The Messiah from the sky. Bringer of miracle objects. Someday he will rise to return our sight and begin the Battle of Volgentol.
Did your god bring any miracle objects that were like weapons? The kind that could take down a giant monster before it destroyed your home village?
Our god had such power and more. Probably. I mean, really, we don't even know what half the stuff in there does.
What's the Battle of Volgentol?
The final battle between humans and Mogs. The end of our entire age.
Sounds promising. Did you say you lost your sight?
Yes, that happens when you blind yourself.
Oh.
If the Dead-Eye God has no need for sight, then neither do we.
Huh. Hey, can I get you guys something?
Like what?
Something to read?
We're blind. Oh, how is she not getting that?
Can I go inside?
You wish to invade our holiest of shrines? Why?
Because it's kind of cold out here?
The Deadeye Pyramid provides sanctuary only for the Deadeye God and his devoted followers when we're on a break. But no one enters the Deadeye Pyramid. No one. Well, unless...
What?
Well...
Bye.
Sense you later. The Deadeye God sees no one.
Bye.
Sense you later.
That's not a good place to hang a ladder.
This pretty window is the solution to the riddle?
Are you asking me or telling me?
Telling you? Nah, that doesn't need a new sun. Especially not a vintage crystal one. This stool is the solution to your riddle.
How's that?
Well, I mean, you could sit on it while you think of the real answer. It's got one too many feet for these shoes. The solution to your riddle is... cloud shoes!
We don't even know what those are, but no.
It does have feet on the bottom, but they're too big for these little cloud shoes. Think about this. You can take down a ladder.
Go on.
And it can rise again and get you out of a pit.
But what about the rotten bed?
Well, just ignore that part.
You can't ignore the riddle of yarn.
That would be a wobbly combination. That's not a good use for a stool. 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 We have one like that back home for making upside down cakes. That would be a wobbly combination.
That's not a good place to hang a ladder.
I don't think that would help the arena get built.
That would be a wobbly combination. That's not a good use for a stool.
Let's cut this ribbon already.
You tell them, non-maiden.
The ribbon is there for your protection. The arena is still under construction.
These fishing poles are useless. All the hooks have been stolen.
No, no, not like that.
Sup, maidens?
Hey, are you guys good with riddles?
Of course we are. Except the kind where there are words that have, like, two meanings.
Oh, yeah, and you think the word means one thing, but it actually means the other thing? Yeah, I hate those.
It's not like that, is it?
Maybe?
See you maidens later.
Ciao!
Sup, maidens?
Okay, now flip it and stick it.
Marshal Dune?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, do you know the answer to the riddle about the pits and rotten bed?
What kind of pits are you talking about?
Huh. Not sure.
Those shell maidens won't share their monster bait with me.
Please, that's terrible.
I know. They won't give me a single drop.
No, I mean it's terrible what a tattletale you are. No perfume will cover up poor sportsmanship, young lady.
How about now? Is the construction coming along better?
Ah, the sand is falling apart, and so am I.
I need to enter the Maiden's Feast.
Child, at this point, we may not even...
Better let you get back to... Looking at this chum trough makes me really happy I grew up in a baking town instead of a fishing town. That's not a good use for a stool. That's not a good use for a stool. Ew. I don't want to put this pretty little crystal in there. Nah, that doesn't need a new sign. I don't want to get my shoes all chummy. Wow. It's getting thicker every second.
Strong stuff, kid. Don't mess with it.
Have you ever seen cloud shoes? They're bent twigs, wrapped in feathers.
Well, the twigs might...
Wait, is this east or west? Hey! Let go! Can't... Please... Oh, boy. I think this was a beautiful snake! If it weren't... killing me! This is tight! I think this was a beautiful snake! If it weren't... killing me! Okay, so do not go that way. Got it. No way. They're just my size. I'm keeping them. Okay, this time, I'm sure I went the right way. Oh, yeah. There's a snake over here. Okay, so do not go that way. Got it. Nah, that doesn't need a new sun. Especially not a vintage crystal one.
Hey, Vella.
Do you know what rises from a rotten bed?
No, but it sounds like one of those fruity riddles my ex-girlfriend Becky was into. Man, I do not miss her.
Catch you later, Curtis.
Beware the trees!
That doesn't just my size.
There. You need to tie some ladders together. Did you hear me?
I don't need a ladder hanging off of me.
Oh, this is not a light situation. I feel that new girl might be involved in this somehow.
This looks like a fountain, but it's...
Well, I'll see you two later. Well, I'll let you get back to your... Hi.
Hi.
Well... I'll leave you alone.
Hi.
So what's new out here?
Are you making fun of me?
Well, I'll leave you alone. Not a good place to hang a ladder.
Hey, the sun part, fell out when I walked by.
Man, I guess the heavy crystal I used for the sun needs a thicker lead around it. Just put it back up there and I'll fix it later.
Hi.
Hey, Vella.
Do you know what rises from a rotten bed?
No, but it sounds like one of those fruity riddles my
ex... Catch you later, Curtis. Hasn't gotten mail in a while.
What's up, maidens?
Hey, are you guys good with riddles?
Of course we are! Except the kind where there are words that...
See you maidens later.
Ciao!
Let's cut this ribbon already.
You tell them!
Looking at this chum trough makes me really happy I grew up in a baking town instead of a fishing town.
Hey, you taking a break, Clarence? Can you hear me up there? Steady. Now to the right. Moving a little bit.
Here she comes again.
Hey, can I get you guys something?
Like what?
Some more holy tear gas?
Oh yeah, here. Just fill that up for me if you could. Thanks.
Bye.
Sense you later.
The solution to your riddle is this empty tear gas container.
How's that?
Sorry. Just taking a shot in the dark.
Is this your secret stink for attracting Mom Chothra?
It's my grandmother's traditional cocktail of musk, pheromones, and animal sweat. And I'm not sharing it with anybody.
Well, I don't need it anyway. Daddy says I exude it naturally.
I can't fill the holy tear gas dispenser with that.
These seagulls seem to... Come to me, old chum. I mean, when is this not going to come in handy?
Okay, okay, so far, so good. Dang us all! Okay, not a problem. Just start again, is all.
Sup, maidens?
This stuff is like love potion for seagulls. Okay, this time, I'm sure I went the right way.
Oh yeah, there's a snake over.
Okay, so do not go that way. Got it.
This stuff is like love potion for seagulls. This stuff is like love potion for seagulls.
Shh! Here she comes again! Halt! The Deadeye.
I've got the riddle solution. Fish guts.
I suppose they could be fish in their prime. And the ocean could be a pit. But it's not hidden. And baby fish don't rise out of it. That would be super creepy. Good effort there, though.
This stuff is like love potion for seagulls.
Watch out for the crosswind.
Ugh, gross, Drusilla. Don't you think I can smell that?
Okay, this time it really wasn't me.
Hey, maybe this perfume is what's attracting them. I'll get rid of it.
Great! Ow! Great idea!
What about me?
Ow! I exude it naturally! She has to save whom she can't. Ow! I'll tell Mog Chothra about you, Drusilla.
Raise
Here she comes again.
The solution to the riddle of Yorn is perfume. Because you put it in your rotten pits.
What about the part with the children?
Oh, yeah.
You don't really put perfume in your armpits, do you?
You can see the whole Maiden's Feast area from up here.
Oh, man. The things monsters go for these days.
Okay, now flip it and stick it.
You made it.
Yeah. After you took that beast hooker away, they eventually left us alone.
Thank you so much, non-maiden.
I want to be in the Maiden's Feast.
Well, maybe we could put in a good word for you, since you helped us with that bird attack.
Yeah, our dads are pretty powerful.
Hey, are you guys good with riddles?
Of course we are. Except the kind where...
See you maidens later.
Ciao!
Now let's see if this one...
Marshal Dune?
Hmm?
I need to enter the Maiden's Feast.
Oh! My, oh my! Now that is how you attract a monster! You are in, my girl! My compliments to your grandmother. Truly monstrous! Now, if there only was going to be a maiden's feast.
Hey, about your bucket hat.
What? What about it?
It looks terrible on you. Might cost you the election.
Please, whom am I to trust? My highly paid stylist or a girl wearing half a dress?
Kay, do you know the answer to the riddle about the pits and rotten bed?
What kind of pits are you talking about?
Hey, about your bucket hat.
What? What about it?
It looks great on you. Very fancy.
What? Fancy? But I'm a man of the people. I'm never going to win this election if I come off as haughty and elite. Here, take this away from me. Thank you, child. I'm firing my stylist tomorrow.
Better let you get back to the feast.
Yes, yes. These maidens aren't going to serve up themselves.
Nice inversion, Clarence. Nice. You know, I think this one looks...
It's already soaking into the ground. I have to catch it when it's fresh.
And now you're decorating me like a Christmas tree? Is there no end to the humiliation?
That would be a wobbly combination. You can still see the grain of the wood.
This will make your sand mixture stick together better.
Really? How do you know?
I'm a baker. I know my ingredients.
At this point, I'd try anything. Hey, Clarence! Bring that load down here, will you? I hope you're right about this.
It's never failed me before.
How many times have you used it?
Never. Let's watch.
becomes a wave. I can't look.
What'd I tell you?
Now that's a sandcastle. Looks like we're in business. I guess it's showtime.
Wait, I'm not ready yet.
What? Well, I owe you one, so I can stall for a little while. But hurry back. I can't keep the beast from coming.
Be right back. I have to get some sort of powerful weapon before Mogchathra gets here. Sup, maidens?
Just waiting around to save the town. Same as always.
Hey, are you guys good with riddles?
Of course we are. Except the kind where there are words that have, like...
See you, maidens. Wait.
Shh! Here she comes again!
Could you remind me how the riddle of your... Can I go inside?
You wish to invade our holiest...
I don't, really, if I'm being completely honest.
Then be gone.
Can I go inside?
You wish to invade our holiest of shrines? Why?
Because you guys are guarding it, so it must be cool.
Oh, it is. Extremely cool. But no one enters the...
Bye.
Sense.
These fishing poles are useless. All the hooks have been stolen. That would be a wobbly combination. That's not a good use for a stool. Sup, maidens?
Just waiting around to save the town.
See you maidens later. Let's cut this ribbon already. I'll let you get back to your... That's not a good use for a stool. Nah, that doesn't need a new sun, especially not a vintage crystal one. That's not a good use for a stool. That's not a good use for a stool. That would be a wobbly combination.
That's not a good place to hang a ladder.
Okay, this time, I'm sure I went...
In case of snake blow, I can't use my... Oh, yeah. In case of snake blow, I need to remember not to come this way.
Okay, so do not go that way. Got it. Hi.
Hey, Vella.
Do you know what rises from a... Catch you later, Curtis. I feel like I should get to know that guy before I steal his art.
That's not a good place to hang.
I feel like I should get to know that. Hey, here's some wood.
That wood is playing a vital security function where it is.
Hi.
Hey, Vella.
Hey, about this art.
Yeah?
What is it?
Well, you know. It's abstract. It's kind of a tone poem, really. I find it does some interesting things with the space between viewer and image.
Okay. Where'd you get it?
I bought it from this slightly shady girl from Shellmound. Said she was selling it to get money to move out of town.
Aren't you bothered by its elitist themes?
I probably would be, if I had such a superficial understanding of the work.
How do you know it's hanging right side up?
Because the dude's little feet go on the bottom, duh.
I like how it matches your decor.
Decor? I don't have a decor. The purpose of art is not decor, man.
Why do you have it up then?
I only had it up there ironically, but I was actually getting sick of it. If you like it, just take it.
Really? Okay. Catch you later, Curtis.
Beware the trees.
Okay, I'm taking this.
Cool. I liked that kind of stuff when I was your age, too.
Someone's ripped the trees out of this painting.
They were looking at me.
What's this supposed to be? A little man with a bad haircut?
I guess at first glance one might see it that way.
Almost ready.
Hurry up, girl. When the beasts arrive.
Better let you get back to the feast.
Yeah.
Shh. Here she comes again.
I have a piece of art here that is the solution to your riddle.
Does it have a pit? Or children?
Not really. Okay, I retract my statement. I have a piece of art here that is the solution. These two pieces do not work well together. I don't think that will improve this art. The stool looks better without it. Putting shoes on a ladder was already pushing it. I have a piece of art here. I'll bet I could make a million off of this idea. I'll bet I could make a million off of this idea.
You guys like art?
We are art.
You guys like art?
Any idea what this is?
Please, unless it's Mog Chothra, I don't even have time to look.
No. Looking at this chum, until I find out what this is, I'd better not immerse it in fish guts. I've got some art that might make you sick.
Is it made of wood?
Actually, I've never seen this material before.
Then I doubt it would make me as sick as the horrors made by your lumberjack friend.
I've got some art. That wouldn't help. No. Okay, this time, I'm sure.
I can't use my hand.
The stool looks better without it.
Oh, I can't use my hands.
That's not a good use for a stool.
I can't use my hands. I can't use my hands.
Okay, so do not go that way. Got it.